What is happiness? Why is it that no matter how many friends you make, places you travel, and promotions you get, that you aren't entirely satisfied, fulfilled to your heart's content? Emotional states are like a biochemical cocktail, with various actions, ideas, and thoughts as ingredients contributing to the final flavor. You see, our biochemical system adapted to increase our chances of survival, not our happiness. The system rewards actions conducive to survival with fleeting, pleasant sensations. These sensations eventually return to neutral or unpleasant ones. To solely identify happiness with pleasant sensations means you will never be happy for long. The Buddha suggested the key to happiness was to reduce our craving for pleasant sensations and not allow them to control our lives. According to the Buddha, we can train our mind to observe carefully how all sensations constantly arise and pass. When the mind learns to see our sensations for what they are, fleeting, meaningless vibrations, we lose interest in pursuing them. In other words, happiness and joy do not depend on outer conditions, which change constantly, but on the experiencer of all phenomenon, mind itself. Some people are content in the midst of deprivation and danger, while others are miserable despite having all the luck in the world. This is not to say that external circumstances do not matter, but it is your mind, rather than circumstances themselves, that determine the quality of your life. Your mind is the basis of everything you experience and of every contribution you make to the lives of others. I'm not advocating that we give up the pursuit of all pleasant feelings. I, for one, am not ready to give that up. I think the key insight here is that our mind determines our quality of life. Yet how much time do we spend paying attention to the content and thought patterns which govern our minds? When are we taught about the importance of this relationship? Many problems, goals, and other things we seek to accomplish are something that promise that, if done, it will allow us to finally relax and enjoy our lives in the present. Generally speaking, this is a false hope. I'm not denying the importance of achieving one's goals, maintaining one's health, or keeping one's children clothed and fed. But most of us spend our time seeking happiness and security without acknowledging the underlying purpose of our search. Each of us is looking for a path back to the present. We are trying to find good enough reasons to be satisfied now. So how does one return to the present? Personally, I have found mindfulness, meditation, and exercise to be extremely helpful for me. But don't misunderstand my experience as the only way to achieve this. This is an insight you must uncover yourself. Happiness is returning to the state where nothing is missing in this moment. People often push back against this mindset of being satisfied in the present moment, confusing being content with complacency, believing that complacency will lead to one never achieving their goals. This is a misconception that leads to unnecessary suffering. I believe it is possible to strike a balance of moving towards a desired future and contentment with the present moment, because the present moment is all you'll ever have.